Number three. The question is, an army contingent of 616 members is to march behind an army band of 32 members in a parade. The two groups are to march in the same number of the columns. What is the maximum number of columns that they can march? Now see, we need to find out the maximum number of columns where the army contingent can march. So whenever there is a case of the maximum numbers, we go for the SCF. So we need to find the SCF of SCF of 616 and 32. So here 616 is greater than 32. So on dividing 616 by 32. So 616 equals to, now we can divide it separately. This will go one time, 32, 11, 2, 9, 5, 3, 2. So we will not go, carry 6. So this will be 9 times, 9 to 18, 288. So this is now 8 and 0. So 8 is the remainder now. So this is 32 into 19 plus 8. So on dividing 616 by 32, we are getting 616 as dividend. This is equals to divisor into quotient plus remainder. Again, we are not getting remainder as 0. So again dividing this divisor by the remainder. On dividing 32 by 8. So 32 equals to 8 into 4 plus 0. Here, because 32 is completely divisor by 8, we are getting remainder as 0. Since we are getting remainder as 0, so SCF would be 8. So the number of columns would be, number of columns are 8. So in the 8 columns they can march. Okay, now coming to the question number 4. Use the Euclid's division lemma to show that the square of any positive integer so this square of any positive integer, it is in the form of 3m or 3m plus 1, in the form of 3m and 3m plus 1, where m is any integer. Again, we will follow the Euclid's division lemma. So Euclid's division lemma is A equals to BQ plus R. A is the dividend and B is the divisor, Q is the quotient and R is the remainder. Here divisor is 3. So B equals to 3. So when we have divisor as 3, the possible remainders would be, so value of R will be less than, this will be less than the divisor, less than 3, but greater than equals to 0. So possible R values of R will be 0, 1 and 2. 0, 1 and 2. So now just following this division lemma, A equals to BQ. So in place of B, write 3q plus r. So for A equals to 3q plus 0, taking r equals to 0. So for r equals to 0, this expression will reduce to 3q plus 0. We can rewrite it, A equals to 3q. So on squaring, because we have been asked for the square of any integer. Square of any positive integer is in the form. So we will square it. So on squaring both sides, so this a square equals to 3q whole square. So we are getting a square equals to 9q square. We can take 3 as the common. A square equals to 3 times, this is 3q whole square. Rewriting it, a square equals to 3m, where m equals to 3 times q square. So we got the first expression, that square of any positive odd integer is in the form of 3m. Now taking it again, for other remainders like r equals to 1 and r equals to 2. So taking the same expression, a equals to 3q plus r, rewriting it, a equals to 3q plus 1, where r is equals to 1. On squaring both sides, on squaring we get a square equals to 3q plus 1 whole square. So a square equals to, on squaring it, so this will square on the basis of a plus b whole square. So this is a square plus 2ab plus b square. So this is 3q square means 9q square plus 6q plus 1. So this is a square equals to, we can take 3 common in this, 3q, or simply taking 3 as common. So this will be 3q square plus 2q plus 1. Here a square equals to 3m plus 1. So writing m equals to, we have taken m as 3q square plus 2q, where m equals to 3q square plus 2q. So this is what the expression we got in the term of 3m plus 1. Again taking the same expression for r equals to 2. So a equals to 3q plus r, a equals to 3q plus 2, taking r equals to 2. So by taking r equals to 2, again squaring on both sides, because we have been asked for the square of the positive integers. So a square will be equals to 3q plus 2 whole square. So we get a square equals to 9q square, 9q square plus 2ab. So 2ab means 12q plus 4b square. So a square equals to, we can write it again in the form of 3 plus 1, 9q square plus 12q plus 3 plus 1. So we can take 3 common from this expression. So it will be a square equals to 3, take 3 as a common. So this will be 3q square plus 4q plus 1 plus 1. So now this expression is in the form of, so write it down, this as m. So we got a square equals to 3m plus 1. Okay, we can again rewrite it as a square equals to 3m plus 1, where m is 3q square plus 4q plus 1.